Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, I want to talk about my second biggest app. Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in ages ago, all the way back on episode 388 from Highlights Time. Highlights Time said, "Hey Eric, you talk a lot about your biggest app, but I'm curious, which one is your second biggest?" All right, I'm going to answer this question, but it's not really a very good answer because the second biggest one is like a clone of the first biggest one. So, have a look at my screen here. So I've talked about this before. My biggest application is Ear Agent. It was called Ear Spy for the longest time. So it's had 5.5 million downloads on Android, and it continues to be the top earner for me. So you see here, we've changed a bunch of stuff. We have like a really nice video for it, which we spent a couple of weeks doing. The annotated screenshots, everything like that. It still says Ear Spy, even though the name's been changed to Ear Agent. I didn't even bother changing that. So that's there. But the second biggest one is called Ear Assist, which, let's have a look at this here. You can see is exactly the same application. So after 6 months after releasing Ear Spy, and it was starting to get a little bit of traction, but not really, I thought, well, why don't we just try to reach a new market? Why don't we do something aimed at people who need hearing augmentation or hearing aid type of things? Because a lot of people were saying in the comments that that's what they were using it for. I'm not really a spy, but I find it easy to watch TV and things like that. So I thought, why don't we just take it and then see if we could remarket it to a different audience as a different application? And you can see here, all we did was we changed it from red to blue and we called it Ear Assist instead of Ear Spy at the time, right? So, and this is the second biggest one. It's had about, over the last several years, it's had just 250,000 downloads on Android, right? This is the kind of thing you couldn't get away with on Apple, I don't think, because they just cracked down 4.3. This is the kind of stuff they frown against, right, is reskinning something. But for me, it made perfect sense because I was trying to reach two different audiences, which would not necessarily be the same people. I didn't want people who are looking for a creepy spy tool to find this nice hearing aid thing and spread the word that way, or the people who look for a hearing augmentation to find the spy. You know, it was just two different audiences, and I want to reach out to them, which in Apple point of view, you would not be able to do because they say spam in the App Store, it needs to be one app, blah, 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 right? They're too similar. Right, so you see here it's exactly the same, but because we haven't had the same downloads and everything like that, I never bothered to change the screenshots. You know, I have a video on here, which is just a video of, unlike the cartoon one, which we try to keep the spy theme here. This is just me talking, like, okay, you click on here, you do this, you do that, all that kind of stuff. So, and that's been the second biggest one. So this is something to think about and this was something that when I first met an app developer who was not me, like I got a call from somebody and talking about some mastermind group, and he was talking about reskinning, right? Because I never heard of reskinning before. And he said, well, you could take your application and maybe you could reskin it to other audiences and other things. Like if you have your bubble game, maybe it could be a panda game or a candy game or whatever happens to be popular at the time. And I started doing that and I started thinking about this application and say, maybe we could just do that and give it more of a medical feel. Like blue is more of a medical color. The red and black was a spy thing. So we did that. And it has brought in quite a lot of money. In fact, when Ear Agent was suspended a couple of months ago, a lot of people were saying, hey, why don't you just re-release it as an ear hearing aid type of thing? And it was like, I already have one out there and it's already, you know, but it doesn't seem to fare well against some of the other ones. So in terms of ranking, for a while it was up there near the top if you typed in hearing aid, but not so much anymore. And it's just sort of there. So it's something to think about if you have an app that's doing well. Is there a way you could like reskin it and maybe try to reach a different audience if there's another audience which would be interested in that type of thing? So anyway, something to think about. Anyway, yeah, and don't think less of me because I released the same code twice in two different places, all right? There's nothing wrong with that. Go to any toy store and you'll see the same toy in blue for boys and in pink for girls, right? They are not breaking the law, right? This is an Apple thing that they go through. So anyway, let me know. Let me know if you think less of me because of that. That's it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow. Oh, yeah.